Welcome again to Expo Today Live. I'm joined now by Sunil Hirani, who is CEO of trueEX at booth 1614. Sunil, tell us a bit about trueEX, where you're at, are you up and running, your structure?
Yeah, so trueEX is both an exchange as well as a SEF. We're focused exclusively initially on the interest rate swaps market. And what makes us different is we offer an anonymous central limit order book, as well as differentiated services like portfolio services to do that allow the buy side to do terminations, compactions, and others and allocations.
Okay. And why did you choose to register both as an exchange and a SEF? What's the reasoning for that?
So the reason we decided to register both as an exchange and a SEF is because we have plans to roll out futures contracts as well. So we want to list those as well as standardized swaps on our exchange, and then to list the illiquid swaps and portfolio services on the SEF. So for example, we have, you know, we announced a deal earlier this year with Standard & Poor's as well as CME, where we're going to create a futures contract that based on the S&P 500, and that'll be distributed on Globex. So that's an example of a product that we will list on RDCM.
Okay. So you'll be broadening out away just from interest rates and going
yes.
into equities
mm-hmm.
and
other. And we have some other ideas in futures for rates, but we wanted the flexibility to deliver to clients, you know, a choice on whether to trade on a SEF or whether to trade on a DCM.
Okay. And in terms of your participants, where are they coming from? Who are you engaging with at the moment?
Right. So we feel we have three primary constituents. So first and foremost, the buy side. So this traditional buy side, whether it's asset managers or hedge funds or GSEs or other firms like that. And the second part is market makers, the traditional dealers. And the third are FCMs. So those are our three primary constituents. So our target market for swaps are participants who currently use swaps.
Okay. And how do you see the landscape shaping up? Because obviously we've had an influx, given
right.
the regulatory deadline, influx of SEFs being registered. How do you see the landscape shaping up maybe in a year or two's time? Where will we be in that
stage? Yeah, I mean, look, we have some immediate issues that the marketplace is grappling with, things like allocations, asset managers, and other hedge funds need an effective way to allocate their trades, number one. Number two, this made available to trade deadline and submissions that people are doing. So those are two very important things that are, you know, here and now. But I think a year from now, I think the marketplace will want to get access to platforms like ours through an agency model, something that has worked so well in the futures market. So I think that's where we'll be, is the marketplace will realize, hey, we can't get direct access to exchanges, and we want to do them through agency sponsorship, similar to how it works in futures.
Great. Well, thank you very much for joining us, Sunil, and good luck with
thank
the future.
Thank you very much, Jim. Thank you.
That's it for now from Expo Today Live, but join us for more later. Thank you.